In this video, you will learn how to create and update SQL query. Let's assume we want to create an SQL query that updates user email verification status and sets it to true or false. And to do that, I will add a new method. Let's call it void update user email verification status. Let's start verification from capital V. And this method will take two parameters. First one will be boolean value, which is email verification status. And another one is string user ID, like this. These two parameters will be passed to my SQL query as named parameters. So I will need to add param annotation, and I will use just the same name in my param annotation for email verification status and for user ID as well. Add param, and I'll copy user ID here. Okay, so I have my method. Now let's create a query. So I will use query annotation, and query annotation takes value. And because this is going to be a native query, I'm going to use native query equals to true. Like this. And now let's define the SQL query itself. So this is going to be an update query. So I'm going to use update and then table users. I'll call it u set user, and I'll copy email verification status from this SQL query, paste it here, equals. And now I will need to include the named parameter here. So I'll use colon and then copy email verification status here. So update users set email verification status equal to the value of named parameter email verification status, where u user ID equals, and now I need to include named parameter of user ID, like this. Okay, so my query I think is ready. There are a couple of more things I will need to do now. Because this is an update SQL query, it is going to modify our record in the database. And in case of modifying SQL queries, we will need to use another annotation, which is called modifying, like this. Let me import modifying. It needs to come from org Spring Framework Data GPA repository. You will use modifying annotation for delete SQL query as well. SQL queries like select do not need to use modifying. Because this is a modifying query, I'll need to use another annotation, which is called addTransactional. Let me import transactional annotation. It needs to come from org Spring Framework transaction annotation. Transactional annotation helps us to perform this kind of modifying SQL queries like delete and update. And if an error takes place in our code after we have updated database record, then database record changes made within these transactions, they will be rolled back and our record in the database will remain unchanged. Now, usually if a method inside of a service class invokes a modifying method or a query which is defined in GPA repository, then this service class method should be annotated with a transactional annotation. And if we want to roll back changes made to a database record in case of an error which take place in a REST controller method, then that method inside of our REST controller class should also be annotated with addTransactional annotation. But since we do not invoke this particular update user email verification status method from either REST controller or from a service class method, it's fine to put transactional annotation here in the repository. But again, usually it is a service class method which is annotated with transactional annotation, or it is both a method in a service class and a method in a REST controller class. Okay, so we have transactional annotation and we have modifying annotation. Now let's create a test method. So I'll switch to user repository test, but before I go there, let me copy the name of the method so I don't have to type it again. And just before create records, I will create a new test method. So that's going to be add test. And this is going to be final void. It will start with test. And then I will paste the name of the method, update user email verification status. And here will be the body. I will now use user repository and I will find my update user email verification status there. Update user email verification status, it takes in two parameters. One is email verification status and another is user ID. Let me define a Boolean value for email verification status. Let's set it to false first. And this is going to be new email verification status, which is going to be recorded to our database table. And let me just update this new email verification status. And for the user ID, I will use just the same value which I used to create the record. So this particular record will be updated with new email verification status. So hopefully when we run this test method, the update user email verification status will work and our status will be updated. But I would like to verify that. And I will use user repository, and this time I will use a query method. So I will look for find by and then user ID like this. And I will give it just the same value of user ID. So I'll use a query method to look a record by user ID, and this method will return user entity, and I will call it stored details like this. So now, if everything was okay and update user email verification status did update my database record, this stored user details should contain email verification status, which is equal to false. So let's validate that. I will create a Boolean value and that will hold stored email verification status equals stored user details get email verification status. And all I need to do now is to assert that these two values are true. So I will assert true that stored email verification status is equal to new email verification status. Okay, so now I can run this test method and see if it's working. I will run a single test method. So I will double click on this test method name so that it is selected. And then I will hold control click and then run as JUnit test to run a single unit test. Let's see if it's working. All right, we get a green bar, which means it works. Now, let's change the status from false to true, and this should still work because if we update the record with email verification status set to true, and then we read that record right away and compare the stored email verification status with the one that we have used in SQL query, then it should still pass. So I will double click on this test method, control click, and then run as JUnit test. And it works. I get a green bar, my test update user email verification status method is working. So the modifying SQL query is working well. We can continue.